when I was 19, I was had a summer job working in a sawmill, and my hand was, I was knocked into a circle saw, and I lost my hand just about midway through the palm.
Well, I was wearing it up to 8 hours a day. Right.
It's very difficult to fit me in a normal prosthesis without it being long and bulky. Where this one, it's just encasing my hand, but it's just giving me the fingers that I'm missing.
Because of the nature of your residual limb, we're having to hold on fairly aggressively.
Having fingers after 26 years, it's like starting over again. As I become more and more familiar with the hand, I'm using it and doing things the way I used to, you know, 26 years ago.
We always like doing eating because we're
all. I'm becoming two-handed again.
Great. Super.
You can see your myo signals on the app. So you can see, you know, that you know, when you're contracting or when you're not.
When I'm carrying things going through a door and I can actually switch hands, or I've got a hand free and I've got my I have my phone or papers in my left hand, which I never could do before. I had to hold it in my hand and turn the knob.
There you go. Excellent. Whoa, three, I like it.
They behave just like real fingers. They bend like real fingers do. I can move them in so many different ways. The thumb is the only one that I need to reposition.
Use that lateral. Good. And so, you know what you might.
This is the only prosthetic provider that I've ever worked with that actually had a therapist that would teach me how to use the tool that they've given me, how to make it function to do the things I want it to do. It helps me day to day in the kitchen, opening jars, doing house projects. I can now hold a nail when I hammer it, hold a screw, hold something in place while I cut it. These seem like small things to the average person, but to somebody before I limb digits, it was a big deal for me.
Was putting a sheet of metal down and the machine malfunctioned as it came down and stamped my hand. I have an amputation from half of the palm and the four fingers.
It's important to keep the elbow down, the shoulder relaxed. Much better for your shoulder.
All right. Okay. I was looking for a prosthetic that will help me do my job better, or at least make it a little bit easier. So I've been wearing my eye limb digits for 18 months, and it takes a lot of time and patience and training to make the most use of out of it. But once you get used to it, you think, it's just does it. So I do day trading full time. From 6 to 3, and after that I work in retail. I'd be stocking shelves, answering phone calls by using my prosthetic hand and taking notes on my left hand. I own a couple properties and I manage my mow the lawn, blowing the snow, shoveling, raking. Most of the time I use my prosthetic hand. And it helps me a lot. Having this prosthetic, I could almost function like my normal hand. You have to come in with the. It may look different. People may notice it right away, but I don't care. It's as long as I could do my job with it. And I like it.
When I was 12 years old that I first lost my three fingers in a corn picker accident, farm accident in October. And then it was just a matter of 4 or 5 years ago when I was 58 years old that I lost my little finger, and that's when the prosthetic became a big part for me of getting usability of my hand again. And it's made a big difference. I was fitted with the ratcheting joint about 6 months ago. The hand looks just like a passive hand, where in fact it's an actual functioning hand that has ratchet fingers in it. You can set the different adjustments for what you want to grip or grasp with the hand. I'm going to use a can pop as an example, where I'll push the little finger in, and I can set that on there. I can push the fingers around it, ratchet them tight and stuff, and now I have complete control of the hand.
All right, Debrin, if you could try this one on, I just need to see what length we need the strap for that one.
Okay.
All right, awesome.
So the ratchet hand is basically inside the finished covered hand and stuff. So this, when you look at that, this is what is inside. And both of them are very unique items for prosthetics. This is more for outside on use, construction-wise, in the field use, where this is more for in the house. The reason I picked this hand over the bionic hand was because of the durability, the strength of it, to handle a shovel. Now I can hang onto a snow shovel or a grain shovel or different items like that and stuff. I can climb the ladder, and I feel more secure with that because of the way it stays on the hand. Use of the prosthetics has become very everyday for me. Like the barbecue I went to this weekend, everybody noticed that I had a hand again. But it was, everybody was pretty impressed with it, the detail of it and the function of it.
So what's nice about this device, Devern, is that you have this interchangeable button here that will allow you to put these different tools in there. So let's have you put this in first. Now you have the ability to position it where you want it to. And once find the position that you want, then you can push it back in. Now it's locked and it's ready to go.
Does the snap feel like it's sturdy enough?
Yeah. But this technology is just absolutely amazing. It's exciting again, to be able to do things you couldn't do before.